New developments tonight in a case of a series of thefts targeting AT&T cell phones. Police confirm one suspect is in custody, and tonight they are actively searching for a second suspect. Both are wanted in the thefts of tens of thousands of dollars of phones throughout central Indiana. RTV6's Jack Reinhardt joins us live outside our Monument Circle studio with details. Jack?
Erica, the two suspects police say were not only working together, but they were related. They're cousins, and they apparently hit every AT&T store throughout Indianapolis and then some. Lonnie Morton and Terry Henton, police say, had mastered the art of stealing cell phones. Investigators say their crime spree began months ago when they targeted this far west side AT&T store, where they learned to defeat the wire security tethers of active phones on display. Police say that it soon became easy to identify Morton and Henton as a team.
He said something to the effect of, "I'm sorry I have to feed my kids. I'm sorry my kids are in the dark. I'm sorry my kids need food." But every single incident, there was that was muttered in some way at each incident.
Police say the pair targeted expensive Galaxy phones that retailed for as much as $500 each. The Castle and AT&T store had been targeted for thefts on three different occasions. Metro police say the pair struck at least 15 AT&T stores throughout Indianapolis and Lawrence. Then police say the suspects began hitting stores in Hamilton County, Hendricks County, and Tippecanoe County. Lafayette police arrested Henton less than 1 minute and less than one block from an AT&T store in Tippecanoe County. Police say the phones were more than likely sold for pennies on the dollar to a middleman before they were shipped overseas. Police say they felt pressure to end the crime spree as soon as possible.
If they were confronted by a store employee, confronted by an officer as they're running out of the business, confronted by another customer, is worrying about whether this was going to escalate into an armed robbery situation or something far worse if this continued.
Now Henton is in custody in Tippecanoe County facing charges of robbery. Lonnie Morton is still at large. He faces multiple felony charges of theft and corrupt business influence. And tonight at 6 o'clock, we'll tell you why police say that cell phones stolen here in Marion County could have been used against our soldiers overseas. Reporting live, Jack Reinhardt, RTV6.
All right, good to see you.